This from Cincinnati, Ohio, which happens to be the home of my parent company, J-Core. I think. I'm not really sure who owns me anymore. It was Premier and J-Core. And now Clear Channel, I think, has purchased us, and maybe somebody else. I'm not really sure who owns me now. But they're out there somewhere, and some of them are in Cincinnati, I'm convinced. Employed at Telecommunications Board of Northern Kentucky, Kenny Young schooled at Southern Ohio College and majored in audio-video production. His interests include astronomy, religion, and, he says, skepticism. Now, what does Kenny have? Kenny has the entire enchilada that you've never heard. Kenny somehow got hold of the Trumbull County police tape of what occurred there. Remember that at the end of confirmation, those of you who saw it? This incredible sighting by police officers in Trumbull County, and at the end it was, of course, dismissed by a skeptic, just like that, as a star. It was a star, he said. And I think when you're through hearing what really happened, the whole thing, you will get a good chuckle out of what the skeptic had to say at the end. Kenny, though, says he is himself a skeptic. We'll find out about that. There is one little Darwin-like thing that I have once again done, and I kind of hurt myself. Not kind of, I did. I don't know if you can see it. It's here on my lip. Actually, not my lip. It's on my inner lip. And No, you're never going to be able to see that. It was last night after I got off the air. As you know, last night we inaugurated video streaming, the G2 system of Intel and Broadcast.com, in partnership, bringing you actual moving video of this radio program. That's right. You can go up there and to my website, download the G2 player. It's free. And then come back after you have the player and click on streaming video, and then you get to see me here moving in actual motion as much as I can muster doing the radio show. And you also get the audio. It is astounding technology, and of course, depending on the speed of your connection, you will see what I regard as astoundingly good video, astoundingly, and we are disseminating this to thousands of you. And it's all free. It's a grand experiment. Enjoy it while you may, because the news is the Federal Communications Commission, and by the way, I'm trying to interview the commissioner of the FCC. I've got a request in for a number of reasons I'll tell you about. We would ask him, of course, about that. But the commissioner, while I've got the thought here, the commissioner has proposed low-power FM, and the radio industry is going absolutely crazy. And I happen to agree with the FCC commissioner on this one, and I would like to have him on the air to talk about it. So if you are a friend of the FCC commissioner, tell him Mark Bell really, really, really wants to talk to him and give him some help with a grassroots movement, because otherwise it's going to get squished. Now, the other item I would like to ask him about is the per-minute charge on the Internet, because they are preparing, I was told by CNN, to start charging you per minute to be on the Internet, even though you're making a local call. And one last time, I want to go back and I want to read you my little bumper sticker, if I can find it, and then I'll tell you about my latest Darwin adventure. Every normal man, this is H.L. Mencken. Every normal man must be tempted at times to spit on his hands, hoist the black flag, and begin slitting throats. End quote. I agree with that one. Well, okay, so we finished last night's program. Pretty tense stuff, right? Because I'm doing this for the first time with moving video. And I decide that I'm going to occupy my mind by fixing an amplifier, working on an amplifier. So I got the amplifier out and got it all opened up, and I was looking at it, trying to figure out what could possibly be wrong. And I reached up to the ashtray and grabbed my cigarette and smoked the wrong end. Put the lit end of the cigarette into my mouth. What happened was the audible portion of that, had you been here, would have sounded like the what followed then, of course, could not be aired. And today, I still have a big red mark on the inside of my lip. This is serious Darwin Award stuff. Why would they give somebody like this a radio program? I'm going to be on Larry King Live next Friday, a week from today, as a matter of fact. And maybe I'll pose that question. Why the hell would they give somebody like me a radio program anyway? I step into clear air, nearly kill myself. At one point, a couple of years ago, I glued my lips together, and now, if I sound strange to you, it's because I took a great big long draw on the wrong end of a cigarette. Pathetic. Really, really, really pathetic. And by the way, you cannot put a Band-Aid there. You know, it's on the inside. God, it hurts. All right, here is Kenny Young. Kenny, hi.
Hello, Art.
How are you?
Pretty good.
You're in Cincinnati.
Yes, sir.
Kenny, why in the world, how in the world, I mean, you have investigated, obviously, other cases. In fact, you might want to run over a few of those. What kind of work have you done? And would you honestly, no, let me ask this first. Are you really a skeptic?
Well, you know, yeah, I'm a skeptic. I'm very cautious about a lot of the material that's out there. I've looked at a number of cases, and looking at quite a few of them from this area, from Ohio, Kentucky, and Indiana.
Yes.
You know, there's some of them that are pretty easily explainable. In some cases, they're not so easy to explain. But
it is. It's
yeah,
kind of
they're
like,
explainable.
Yeah, it's kind of like the reports we had from Peter Davenport, which were quite accurate about an object that was streaking up. And was seen with a bright, very specific tail of flame on it. Turned out to be a rocket launched from Vandenberg at 2:30. The sightings we had were at 2:34 in Southern California. And so what they saw was what they described. They called it a UFO. It is now simply an IFO, Identified Flying Object.
Right, right.
So there is reason to be skeptical. But with regard to what happened in Trumbull County, you've heard the whole thing, and we haven't yet. We're about to. Are you skeptical? They had a skeptic on confirmation, and I know you know about confirmation. You saw it, right?
Oh, sure. I was on it, right.
You were actually on it.
Yeah. The gentleman that was giving his explanation for the event.
The star.
Well, you know, it sounds ludicrous.
Yes,
we all pretty much recognize that. When he comes on NBC and announces that this is all due to stars or twinkling stars, and we look back at what happened with the officer and his patrol cruiser that shut down, and we'll hear this on the tape coming up, by the way. We don't really think that he's, you know, looking at this quite honestly. There's reason, however, we can go into the story. We can see where he's coming from with that. But I do have a problem, yeah, with what he's saying there.
Can we? In other words, a star could hover over your patrol car, slam a giant light down on it, cause your engine to go out, and then when the star twinkles in some other prescribed manner, your car starts back up again.
Well, here's what I want to do. I want to try to maybe get into this and look exactly at this particular account and see where he's coming from with the star explanation that he's advanced. And I want to show why that in this case there's serious problems with that explanation.
No kidding.
Okay.
All right, listen. First of all, I want to know where you got this tape.
Well, this whole event started from it was more or less something that I kind of blundered upon. I was looking into another case, and this was a UFO report from. Liberty, Ohio, is what it was called, that a researcher by the name of Leonard Stringfield from
here
in Cincinnati.
I know the name.
He reported on in one of his status reports, I believe. And the report said something like a lime green ball of light seen overhead smashes into ground, chief of police witnesses. And according to how the story went from that point, a clandestine recovery team from Wright-Patterson Air Force Base supposedly came out and retrieved some kind of object. So I was, just fishing around through some of these reports of Leonard Stringfield's, and I saw this one. And I said, well, hey, you know, this is something maybe we can follow up on. So
in other words, one case led to another.
Well, here's how. I called directory assistance to get the telephone number for the Liberty Police Department.
Right.
The operator that was helping me out with the call actually gave me a wrong phone number. She gave me the wrong Liberty, Ohio. And instead of giving me the Liberty Police Department, which was located actually near Dayton, I was given the phone number to Liberty Township.
You're kidding.
A department that was actually in northern Ohio near Youngstown. I didn't know this. I had no idea this was a wrong number, so I called the department.
Yes.
And I said, well, you know, I'm calling about a UFO sighting. I know this is going to sound crazy, but I'm actually investigating some details about a UFO sighting. Oh, that was 2 years ago was the response I got. And so I just started taking notes, and, of course, I didn't know I had a wrong number. And as I started gathering these details, I saw a picture emerging that was not what I had initially, you know, set out to look into. But
gee
of course,
whiz, Kenny, you know, this is how some of the greatest scientific discoveries of mankind have been made, by total accident.
Well, you know, Art, it was like a 2 week time period when I was actually making these phone calls before I totally realized that this was a separate account altogether.
2 weeks you
Two
were on
weeks,
this?
I had talked to maybe about a dozen people.
In other words,
finally I said, this is not right. I said, now, how come I don't have the details here like I set out to gather?
In other words, you were getting an entirely different story than
exactly.
the one you thought you were investigating. But you went on investigating for 2 weeks. Well,
and
maybe
then,
now
then,
I don't feel
then,
so bad now. Smoking the wrong side of a cigarette.
And then I looked at this and I said, well, you know, this is not the same case. And then right then I knew that there was, you know, there was something rotten in Denmark, so to speak. And
or
at that
Ohio.
Point, I kind of set the original report aside, and I started, doing some hardcore research into what was being reported here.
Well, all right, let us begin by asking this. What occurred in Trumbull County, you just said at the time you were investigating, was 2 years prior, right?
Right. Well,
so where was the press on what happened in Trumbull County originally?
They were there.
I didn't see
it. The press was there. The press was on top of the story, but interestingly enough, which makes this story quite interesting, they didn't report it.
Ha ha. Well, that accounts for my not hearing it.
Well, we're going to hear it. We're going to hear on the tape.
Oh, I understand.
Reporters.
But you're saying that mainstream type reporters were there. They covered the story and didn't report it.
We're going to hear a Youngstown area. Television station, which is a Channel 33
right.
in Youngstown, a reporter that's in the newsroom, and in some cases I think this is pretty widespread where they have police scanners in newsrooms and radio stations and so forth.
Absolutely.
Where they listen to this, and they're going to start hearing this, and they're going to call in, and that's even going to be reflected here on the 911 tape.
Oh,
the reporter calls
kidding.
In.
Oh, you're kidding. So he was well aware of the story, and you're telling me they never aired anything about it.
Exactly. And that's what makes this story pretty interesting.
It sure does.
And regrettably, Art, you know, I realized that the confirmations piece didn't probably have a lot of time.
That's right. They did.
This would have been a real compelling part of the story, is to make note of the societal factors involved in keeping the story from the public.
Kenny, did you call that television station? Did you follow up at all?
Oh, sure, sure.
And did you ask them, hey, guys, gals, why didn't you report that which you investigated?
Right, right.
What did they say?
Well, it's kind of like you're, you know, not a runaround, but just basically a fudging out of the issue. Well, you know, we were off the next day, and really, there was nothing to follow up on, and you know, nothing ever came of it.
What?
And that's usually the...
That many sightings by police officers and others, and nothing, no story? What?
There you go.
Oh, Kenny, come on. Come on. If it was even half as dramatic as was depicted on Confirmation, then how could they? And they heard all this, right? You said they had a scanner.
Right, right. You know, it baffles me. I can sit here and scratch my head over it, you know, and try to wonder. If it were me, you know, in the newsroom or in the capacity to write a news story, of course I'd have the inclination to follow up on it, you know.
Maybe that's why you're not employed by a television station, Kenny.
Okay.
Now, you still haven't answered my question. And my question was, how did you get these tapes?
Well, based upon when I blundered upon the story back in 96, and that's where I followed up on it. And from what I could gather, I had some remarkable details of a saucer, a flying saucer,
mm-hmm.
With structure that rotated as if it were on an axis.
Mm-hmm.
I took all of this this data. I compiled it into a report, and I posted it on the Internet on my website. And it sat there for about 2 years, basically, as a report. And I get a kind email from a gentleman who is actually with the Trumbull County 911 Center. And he sends me an email last year to tell me that he saw my report on the Internet. And he said,
let me interrupt you. Sorry. You said website, and I suddenly looked down and realized you do have a website.
Sure.
I'll tell you what. I don't think we have a link to it yet.
I think Mr. Rowland does.
Keith does have it up. Oh, good for Keith. He's ahead of me because I forgot to tell him about this. So, excellent. Prepare for a little bit of bandwidth cost because a lot of people are going to go see your website. You think your site can handle it, or will it crash?
I guess we'll find out here.
Yeah, we'll find out. All right. So, now, back to where did you get the tapes?
Well, I get a email, and a gentleman tells me, he says, we read your report on the Internet. We work here at the 911 Center. We've never heard of this. We were fascinated by this, and we looked into it, and yes, this really did happen.
Oh.
And they conducted, this gentleman, plus I think another gentleman, conducted a little inquiry, acting as private citizens at the department.
You're talking now about people at the department or at the 911 Center?
The 911 Center.
The 911 Center.
And they conducted a little inquiry, and they were able to retrieve something I was never able to get back in the 96 phase of the investigation.
What was that?
A date of the event, and that's what I sought after.
What was the date of the event?
December 14th, 94.
December 14th of 1994. All right, Kenny, hold on. We'll get right back to you. Now, I think we're leading up to Kenny telling us that somebody in the 911 dispatch center sent him the tapes, but you never know. So we'll finish that up, and pretty soon we're going to get to playing these tapes for you, the entire, almost totally uncensored hour and some odd minutes. We'll be right back. In a moment, we're going to find out if Kenny is the one who provided NBC with the tapes that you're about to hear. Somehow Kenny got his hands on them. We are about to find out. If I was judging his story correctly, it sounds like someone in the 911 center sent him the tapes, which is in itself sort of in a, as Stan Friedman would say, in a gray basket to do such a thing. But he's got them, and you're going to hear them, because I'm going to let them be played. Okay, here we go again. Kenny, you're back on the air, and we're warming up to how you got these tapes.
Okay. Well, like I was saying, the gentleman there that saw the report on the Internet sent me a little letter in the mail,
mm-hmm.
saying they'd retrieved the date, And how they did this was quite interesting. They apparently, as a joke or something at the 911 center, or as a friendly thing that they do at the center, they clip out little articles of the, in the newspaper and make little false headlines. And they may have done this like every now and then, like if a story came up or something, where they clip out little letters out of a newspaper. They assemble them together and makes a funny little headline, and they maybe file it away somewhere.
You mean like a ransom note?
There you go.
Yeah, where you'd cut little words out of a paper and string them together, demanding
right.
ransom, right?
So when they began to check around there, and they would ask their associates and coworkers, how about that UFO incident? When did that happen? Do you recall it? You know, I guess the one thing led to another, and finally they found the date by a silly little gag a headline that someone had cut out and left around somewhere.
You sent me a copy of it. I've got it.
Well, actually, what you've got there is something that I received when they sent me the tape, and I thought that was real interesting, amusing little thing.
When they sent you the tape.
Exactly. So I got an email that said, check your mailbox.
Right.
Something is on its way, and I was I kept my eyes on the mailbox for a day or two, and then you know, there it was. The tape came, and I listened to it, and I was thunderstruck by what I heard.
And this little joke headline that they put together, people in 911 centers, I used to do it myself, at the right time. They've got a lot of time in their hands, and then, of course, it gets frantic. But you do have moments. And so they pasted this thing together out of headlines, which came with a tape that says what, Kenny?
Well, the one I'd received, I don't think it was the same one they had there, because the one that they had had a date. That they were able to look at the date on the newspaper that they clipped it out from. The one I have, and I think I sent it to Keith there for if he posted it, I don't know, on your site, because I didn't have any way to do that here. But it's a page that says, for the record, get ready for hot stuff. Be prepared for an alien star watch coming to our area as Trumbull County Police attempts high-speed chase of a UFO. And you have the 911 tape.
And you have the 911 tape. So this is no doubt some little goodie they prepared for you when they sent the tape.
Exactly.
Exhibiting their usual habits of putting together cutesy little headlines. So here you are in your mailbox. It arrives. Are you certain? Can you be certain, Kenny, that somebody in the 911 center would be the person who sent it to you?
Oh, yes. And, in fact, the gentleman put his name on the email, and I did verify this. I called the 911 center, and I spoke. Very professional people, very courteous and very nice. And it's thanks to them that we have this information. And I think that they saw the need to bring this the details of this forward.
My God, honesty in an agency type in a police department. What a refreshing concept.
Well, yeah, the people that actually worked several weekends in a row to put this tape together, and we'll get into some of that, I think, as we can listen to the tape and how it was recorded. It did take a lot of effort.
Well, then, my brothers and sisters at the 911 center there in Trumbull County deserve my thanks and your thanks and everybody's thanks for getting this out.
Exactly.
That was actually a rather heroic thing for them to do. Three cheers for them.
That's... And even still, Art, it was very courageous for the people that have participated in the confirmation piece to go on camera.
Well, this was going to be my next question. Yes, it was courageous to go on camera, but I've got to ask, where did NBC obtain their copy of the audio that was used? Was that from you, or did they go back to the 911 center?
Well, actually, I believe after I posted some of this information on the Internet, a gentleman, CNI News editor Michael Lindemann.
I know Michael, yes.
Great guy. He posted, I think, on the CNI News an article about this.
I see.
Next thing I know, I get an email from a gentleman, Starling Price. He's the producer. Confirmation.
And so the fact of the matter is, NBC got it from you.
Right.
Whew. All right. How did you feel about giving it to NBC? Were you happy to do it, looking forward to how it might change people's minds or affect their thinking on the subject, or what was your thinking about?
Yeah, I was kind of excited that, that this case would receive maybe some attention. You know, I didn't know of the confirmation program and, you know, of what the other content of the show would be.
Of course. You never do. Even if you're on the shows, Kenny, I can tell you that rarely do you understand what the content is going to be until you see the final product. When you saw it, since you saw it, give us your opinion on confirmation in general. I'd be very interested, since you were on it, since you were part of it. What did you think?
Well, you know, like my hat's off to the producers and for getting these courageous police officers to go on camera. That was really a feat right there. As far as the rest of the program, you know, I've got my my feelings about the abduction scenario, and I'm not really too much into that.
I have some skepticism about that as well, but yeah. It's an event that has not occurred to me, so I can't really speak.
Right. But, you know, it was kind of lumped in there, and well, so be it. I guess that's just the nature of the beast. You know, we kind of have to deal with that.
Well, I interviewed the producer of that program on the night prior to its airing, and he told me on the air, Kenny, that he thought that the final segment, the Trumbull County segment, was the most important, the most impressive part of the entire program. I would have to say that runs kind of hand-in-hand with the implant business with Dr. Lear. But Trumbull County was awesome.
Well, I got a tremendous response after the program aired, a great reaction to the piece.
And so people contacted you by email or on your website or whatever?
Oh, sure. Yeah, and in fact, I guess let me give that out real quickly here.
Well, you can, but we do have a link. Everybody probably is up on my site, so you can just go down to Kenny's name and click on it, or Kenny,
it's
go right
at UFO Research Cincinnati website.
UFO, that's in capitals?
UFO Research Cincinnati is the name of the website.
Right, but what I'm saying is when you go to enter it into your web browser,
okay,
you have listed it here as UFO, capital letters, capital R, and then lowercase research.
Yeah. Well, actually, the URL address is home.fuse.net/UFO.
That's home.fuse.net/UFO.
Exactly.
All right. That's what I really needed to know. Okay. So you'll get lots of traffic on your website, I'm sure. Let's see. What else do I need to know before we begin playing this tape? Your personal reaction when the skeptic came on at the end and said, 'twas a star.
Yeah, how about that? Well, you know, I want to see the science involved in drawing this conclusion. I have some concerns about possibly that the gentleman that made his comments, I want to know the breakdown of his investigations. I want to see if he's taking the time to maybe contact some witnesses involved. You know, it's one thing to go about quoting some investigator's handbook and talking about how the twinkling of stars and you know, it can cause this common misperception. But how much science was involved in his determination?
Yeah, they probably have a chapter in their little handbook about how to debunk even the most obvious and real cases of UFO or saucer sightings.
When we get into the details of this, we're going to see that the twinkling star scenario is viable here, not in every case, but as things later progress, I can see where that explanation can be
That will be then as a result of your audio tapes, because it sure as hell wasn't the result of confirmation. Now, in confirmation, if you weren't laughing when you heard the fellow talk about star as an explanation, then you weren't watching, you weren't listening.
Right. Well, here's the thing that I'm kind of concerned, and this is what interests me, is the skeptic mentality. And I kind of have this myself, but at least I would like to see some honesty here. to apply this explanation, you would have to delete data that's involved in the case. You'd have to ignore key detail.
You'd have to delete data.
You'd have to go in there and shape the case and conform it to your own explanation. And that's not what we want to do. We want to be objective in our approach, and we want to look at this and use science behind our intent to apply an explanation. And if we can't do it, then doggone it, let's just call it the way it is and say, well, this is something unusual, this is unexplained right now. But, you know, with his explanation of twinkling stars, I think there's a little bit to be desired there.
I see. You're being very kind. But you are a fellow skeptic.
At times. I have my days.
You have your days. All right. Well, then, let us, why don't we begin, what the hell, give them a little teaser here before the top of the hour and begin. So you have gone out and you have purchased a unique little mechanism to allow this to be played on the air, and we hope it's going to sound okay.
We'll hope it works. It's a technical situation here on this end of the phone, but what I'll do is I'll play from the beginning here, I'll just set the stage real briefly. A number of calls from people in the area have began calling the 911 center to report a UFO that's hovering low over homes.
Hovering.
At this point, we'll just go ahead and pick it up as the tapes begin.
All right. Here we go.
County Dispatch, may I help you?
Yeah, did you get any reports of any objects in the air about 15 minutes ago?
Somebody called in, but I really don't know what that would be.
I mean, it was very strange.
Okay.
Looked like a back end of like one of them fighter planes, you know, like a plane coming out the back.
Okay. Was it just like moving at a slow rate of speed?
It wasn't a slow rate, it was a fast rate, but it was coming down.
It was coming down?
Yeah.
Like straight down or at an angle?
Like an angle.
At an angle?
Yeah,
okay.
I mean, it wasn't real big in the, in the back.
Okay.
The plane.
All right. Well, I'll tell you what, we'll check with the air base in Vienna and see if they have any report of anything in the area.
Yeah, okay, thank you.
Okay, right. Bye-bye. 996. By a CC, actually two calls in of a vehicle in the sky, unknown object above Sampson Drive. Have you noticed anything?
Hi, really?
That's affirmative, sir.
What's the location?
The area of Sampson Drive.
What's the song?
Sir, he just advised in the air, in the sky. He didn't advise direction.
998.
998, cut.
Did he give you a description on the object?
Public service, sir. I'll give you further.
Okay.
Bob, I swear to God, four calls in on an unidentified object over Liberty.
Four calls?
Four calls on an unidentified flying object.
Come on down, take a look. All right, we'll check it out.
You want me to call the air base and see if there's anything in the area?
I'll take a look.
I swear to God. You want to hear the call?
Come out here and choke
you. You want to hear the call? Wait a minute, I'll let you hear the call. Did you think I'm lying?
I believe you.
No, I swear to God, listen. Please.
Listen to this one.
What's that?
No, go ahead. Hey, I don't care if I find an object.
Here. I'm stroking the hell out of this guy. Was it moving at a slow rate of speed? Did it dip directly down? I'm going to start to freaking panic. You guys got freaking UFOs over there?
Yeah, ask them if they got any Fox in town.
Huh?
Ask them if Fox is in town.
If Doc is in town?
Fox.
Spock? Oh, you mean like Generation Star Trek thing?
Okay.
Smart ass. They've got all of their forming the sequel. They're all filming the sequel right here in Liberty. You let me know. Oh, shit, if you get abducted, who am I going to call? OSB?
He'll
beam Toby up. I'd spit his ass so fast out of that friggin' machine. I swear to God, this is our fourth or fifth call on it.
All right,
bye-bye. Okay. To our knowledge, we've had four different calls, and this particular one came over Sampson.
Different areas on Sampson itself.
Yes, they just said in the sky. That's all we have, in the sky.
Okay. Out in the area.
Out in the area, checking for an object in the sky. Copy at 30 after.
Yes, Art.
God, Kenny, this is great. She was really getting carried away with herself there, wasn't she?
Oh, sure, but that's part of the enjoyment of hearing the tape.
Oh, it really is. There are some difficult-to-hear areas. What's happening, of course, is the audio has been recorded several times and is compressed anyway. So you've got to listen carefully, folks, but I got a lot out of that, Kenny.
Okay.
That lady was really entertained, wasn't she?
Great personality.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
Yeah, oh, absolutely.
I think as we go along here, we can maybe take some notes about what we hear in this part. We're getting the picture that the 911 center is being alerted to a situation that's being called in by citizens in the area.
Right.
Now, twinkling stars, some people could maybe mistake them for UFOs. It's kind of a stretch to think that you're going to get a lot of people in the area that's going to go out and see twinkling.
There's one little problem here, Kenny. If it was a twinkling of stars, then police departments all over the United States with clear skies should have been inundated with similar twinkling star calls.
Well, yeah. The inference, I guess, the theory goes that there's a refraction of the atmosphere. The light is being refracted through the atmosphere a certain way to cause certain colors. In fact, there's a case here from this area. I was actually in Claremont County traveling with a researcher, Charles Stewart.
All right, listen, you can pick up on that story
okay.
as we get back. But I'm sorry. Twinkling in a certain way with the atmosphere just above Trumbull County? No, I don't think so. I don't think so, but you're going to hear it all tonight. I'm Art Bell. This is Coast to Coast AM.
This is Coast to Coast AM from the Kingdom of Nye with Art Bell.
Back again to Kenny Young in Cincinnati. Kenny, you're back on the air again.
Thanks a lot, Art.
Okay. So where do you want to pick this up now?
You
were commenting on their attitude at the beginning of this with the calls.
Right. Before the break, I was just going to make brief mention. I was traveling through Claremont County, Ohio, about maybe 3 years ago with a fellow researcher, Charles Stewart. And we were looking into a UFO sighting in that area, and while driving at night, we saw a star But, when we first saw it, of course, we were kind of misled by this, and we stopped the car and we looked at it. So I'm saying this just to illustrate that stars can be misidentified. I'm guilty of that. I had that happen to me once.
Me
but
too.
Here's the catch, though.
Me too.
Here's the catch. It took us 30 seconds before we realized it was a star.
Well, what you're actually seeing is an optical conclusion. In other words, as you fixate your stare at the star, Venus is a great example.
Right.
It appears to be going up or down or sideways. However, I too know what that is, and it doesn't take a great intellect to discern that you are coming to an optical conclusion and you are seeing a star. Now,
so we drew a conclusion within about 30 seconds. Now, contrast that with this case in which you have many people, police officers, astute citizens.
Are we to assume, with the earlier explanation, Kenny, that the refracting atmosphere was hovering only over Trumbull County?
Well, let's look at that real close, though. Some of the citizen advisements that came in, a gentleman that called first that we heard, he said it looked like the back end of a fighter jet, flames coming out of it. We're going to get into some more calls, I think, that will discuss even stranger details. Let's pick it up here at this part where the reporter from the station there in Youngstown, Ohio, Channel 33, catches wind of this. And this is one of the oddities about the story is that this never came out. But here we go with the part where the reporter calls.
Go, Kenny.
County Dispatch, can I help you?
Yeah, I do. This is Stacy from 33. This is going to sound really dumb. I hear Liberty Police are in an area that I got a call about a little bit ago. A woman called, claimed she saw something in the sky.
Yeah, you called me a little while ago.
Okay. I hear they're out there and they've got another call.
Yeah, we finally got one on it somewhere.
What the woman told me was on Sanson Drive, like midway in the block, there's a vacant lot or something.
Hold on, I'll let you talk to the Liberty Dispatcher.
Okay.
County Dispatch, may I help you?
Hi, dear. This is Stacy from 33.
Hi, Stacy. How are you?
I got one of your...
Did you really?
This woman was almost...
Sorry.
She saw something. She told me that the area was like Sampson Drive. There's a vacant field midway through the block.
They're telling me this too, but it's probably some weather balloon or something. You know what I mean? They're checking the area, but I really, these UFO calls are getting out of hand.
I don't know what it is.
If it was, what the hell did they come to Liberty for? There's no intelligent life in Liberty. Come on. We're telling everybody they're doing a sequel to this, what's that new Star Trek movie? Generation.
Louis Green, no noise.
No noise.
It was low flying and took off.
Oh, come on.
Fifth Avenue.
Are you sure? It's driving up Fifth Avenue Extension. Now, they'll be.
Not that. You're flying. It came down and just zooped over it with a big glowing object.
Wow, we got four calls on it. The last guy said it was a fighter plane. So you tell me that I would do a big news story on the water and Liberty and the effects on the people. Because these people are clearly afflicted. But I appreciate the tip. I'll let them know some more on it. I dispatched it because God only knows my luck. It would land here, abduct some people, and I would be in trouble for my dispatching.
I was impressed because I heard the way you dispatched it, and I said she's trying real hard not to break.
And I'm working with the biggest jokers on the force tonight, so it's real hard not to.
Lucky.
Well, if we do run into a UFO, I swear I will call you personally.
Okay.
We'll give you an exclusive. Okay. Right. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
County Dispatch.
This is Liberty Police.
Pardon me?
Am I calling the Liberty Police?
What you need, ma'am?
I wonder, did you have anyone call you about a strange plane or airplane or something in the air?
Yeah, they're checking it out.
Yeah, I just saw it on Sampson Road.
Where?
On Sampson Drive.
Okay.
It was coming down Sampson Drive.
It was almost, it looked like it was, I don't know what it was. It was a flying saucer or what it was. It wasn't an airplane. It was not an airplane. It was going off the road.
Are you the same lady that called Channel 33?
No.
Okay. All right.
You must have had calls, other calls in order, huh?
Yeah, not many, a couple.
Yeah. All right, thank you.
What did it look like, ma'am?
It was like a, almost like an iridescent color. It was like a bluish purple, you know, it was like a long streak. You know, like it had, it almost was like a, it had fire coming out of the back of it.
Okay.
You know, maybe it was, I don't know what it could have been, if it was, I know it wasn't an airplane.
Okay, ma'am, I'll let them know.
All right.
All right, bye.
Good.
Okay, CC spot me, said she appeared to be hovering about 50 feet off the ground, heading towards Sodom Hutchins, so I'm going to be checking that area. It's supposed to be a large object with a lot of lights on it.
Sir, I have another report at Sampson Drive, and also we've been advised by caller to the media. Media informed us it was a red, it was a blue-green object hovering, no noise. It was in the area of Fifth Avenue Extension.
I'll go that. That Fifth Avenue Extension just came in.
This is just in now.
This is incredible stuff. Absolutely incredible. Now, before you launch, I want to launch. There are two things here, as we consider the star scenario.
Okay.
Number one, flying saucer coming down Sampson Drive.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you have seen a star twinkle. I have seen a star twinkle. At no time did I consider it coming down a street that I was on or adjacent to. How about you?
Well, here we go. Now, this is where I had some of the details from witness interviews back in 96, and I never, ever considered a star explanation for this based upon the descriptive comments I received. That's why when I really started looking into this, I seriously considered a helicopter explanation.
The other comment, 50 feet off the ground and large. Now, that's not a star. I'm sorry, Kenny. I can't even continue, at least based on what I've heard to now,
right,
to even reasonably.
Well, let's call it the way it is. The star explanation is pretty well trounced right here.
Trounced. It's stomped upon and laughed at.
Okay. we'll hand that to you. We'll give you that.
Well, all right. I don't see how any reasonable person could conclude otherwise. Come on, coming down the street, that isn't the way you describe a star. At best case, you describe a star as a pulsating, slightly moving up and down or sideways kind of thing, depending on your vision, but never, ever coming down the street.
We're going to hear some more descriptive details upcoming that's also going to confound the armchair theorist. I want to say that looks at this and tries to put a dismissive explanation like that on the case. We're going to hear some details that will be most intriguing, I think.
All right, Kenny, stay right there. Ladies and gentlemen, you are listening to The Real Thing. This occurred in Trumbull County. What you're hearing is from the Trumbull County 911 Center, provided for us by Kenny Young, who also got it for NBC. But, of course, NBC was able only to air a very small portion of this. Then they trotted this fellow out, who said it was a star. My foot. There will be explicit language ahead, as there already has been. If there are children in the room, you don't want them to hear it. Then scuttle them out of the room. This is Coast to Coast AM.
This is Coast to Coast AM from the Kingdom of Nye.
That's exactly what it is. My guest is Kenny Young. He's a UFO investigator / researcher, or the other way around. And what he has in his hands is hot as a firecracker. It is the entire, unabridged, with the exception of two F words, I believe. The rest of the language stays in there, so be advised. There is language in what you're hearing. And it made sense to leave the bulk of it in. In fact, if I could have left the F words in, I probably would have. Star coming down the street, 50 feet high. A star, you know what a star is, right? A star is a sun. Looks like a little pinpoint of light out there, except for our star, of course, which keeps us warm and does many other things. But look at that star, 50 feet off the ground. Kenny, welcome back.
Thank you, Art.
Where do we go from here?
Well, let me give a brief review of what we just heard. The officer was dispatched to the scene of the disturbance there on the Sampson Drive vicinity, and he briefly made reference. It's kind of hard to catch. He said, "CC, stop me," and said the lights were right above my house.
That's right.
I got some additional details about that during my interview about 2 years ago with a gentleman. He said that he encountered an elderly gentleman that was wandering in the roadway, and if you saw the confirmation piece, you would have caught this. It was the person that was walking his dog, and he appeared in the headlights of the police car.
Yes.
As the car was en route to the scene. And so this person told the officer that the object, he said, was right above my house.
Mm.
And then he said the object then moved off down in a certain direction. So from this point, the dispatcher is going to contact the FAA tower operator at the Youngstown airport.
Gee, finally beginning to sort of take this seriously.
Okay, here we go.
All right.
Yes, sir. This is Ryan from Liberty Township Police Department in Youngstown, Ohio. We have a report of some flying object in our jurisdiction, in our area, above the Sampson Drive, Fifth Avenue extension area. I could not give you any kind of traffic, you know, direction that would help you know that area. Do you know of anything that should be in our airspace this time, close to the ground?
Right
this now, is not a prank phone call, I swear. You can call me back and verify.
Look at the radar scope, and I go 60-mile diameter of Youngstown, and there is nothing out there.
Oh, shit.
Not even anything up high.
We've got five accounts, five calls in on this.
Yeah.
Something's flying in our area, and it's low to the ground. Would you be able to monitor, like, a Cessna or something with a light on it?
Well, you know, if it was, do you mean visibly?
No, with the radar.
Oh, with the radar, it depends on how high it is and where they are. You know, if it's low radar coverage, so there isn't any.
Okay, now I get a text to go here and tell them something, and I don't want to say you couldn't find anything. Is there any, like, clause I might use that might be like a personal aircraft or something that might be used at night or something?
Could be. Could be, you know, it just could be anything. As far as, you know, any kind of helicopter traffic or anything down low, they don't have any kind of requirements to
it made no noise
unless they're coming into the airport here.
Okay, so you have no communications with helicopters. It could be something like that.
Yeah, it could be a helicopter.
Okay.
The helicopter's particularly flying
low. Okay. All right, I'm buying this 100%. But
are you, you know, is that location anywhere near a hospital?
We are close to a hospital, but the location is away from, it's as low as they said it was to the ground, it would be approximately 5 miles away from the hospital. We're closer to, that end of town is closer, like, out towards the Vienna line, Vienna Air Base area, and that's what I thought maybe it was related to.
Yeah, we haven't had anything going on, you know, nothing coming from that direction.
Okay.
Half an hour ago.
Then I'm going to
guys just go out here northbound, climbed up high, and nothing's going on around here.
Okay, I am going to advise you of this. You could take it and file it under G and in your garbage can if you want to. We've got accounts of this. Hold on 1 second for me. Okay, I've got 4 to 6 calls. Hold on 1 second. Okay, at this time, I've had 4 to 6 calls come in about a lit object, well-lit object, blue-green lights, hovering above the area of Sampson Drive and Fifth Avenue. The object was low to the ground, did not make any noise, hovered there for some time, and then continued moving down the Fifth Avenue extension road. My unit was out. He caught something he thought was red. Somebody described it as the end of a fighter pilot plane. I don't know what the hell kind of lines of continuum they're drawing here. I don't see any, but this is what I was advised of, so I wanted to call.
Okay, well, you know, I have a, if I was downstairs in the radar room, I would have a finder with some phone numbers. We have some 800 numbers as far as identified flying object reports and things like that. If you wish, you can catch, during business hours.
Like I said, I don't know.
I don't see anything out there, nothing on the radar scope. I haven't seen anything, and, we don't really do anything with the information.
Okay. I thought I'd pass along in case somebody was maybe flying without permission and, you know, night flying or something like that. I didn't know what was going on, but as long as I've done my job passing along, and I don't want to sound like a crackpot, but that's what we've got in so far.
Right.
Okay, thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
998 radio.
998,
good. I'm really clear. I don't see anything right now. What I saw, I have no idea what I saw. It just might have been just a light up in the sky. I don't know. Be in service.
Copy. 25 guys.
You may want to advise the surrounding jurisdictions to stop and interrogate if they come across us.
Copy.
James Road and Sampson Drive out in Liberty.
Yes, ma'am.
I wondered if I heard on the scanner where they were looking for that big blue.
Right, ma'am.
Yeah, did they find anything yet?
Not yet. The dispatcher for Liberty Township right now, she's speaking with the air base to see if they have possibly something in the area at this time.
Oh, I see. Yeah, I heard on scanner. I thought it was one of flying saucers since it wasn't very far from the ground.
Well, that's why she contacted them in case it would be a blue balloon.
Is the news media in on that?
I beg your pardon?
Did they call the news on that?
I have no idea.
Yeah, I thought I heard in the sky that they did. But they think it might be from the air base.
Right. As I said, the Liberty Dispatch is on the phone right now speaking with the air base.
And they think that's where it's from.
Yes.
All right. Well, thank you.
Okay,
bye-bye.
Ma'am. Bye-bye. We've contacted the FAA administration, and one, they've advised nothing on the radar scope within a 60-mile radius of Youngstown. They did advise they have no communication with any helicopters or any private-owned vehicles, air vehicles.
They're not aware of anything then, right?
Negative. He checked the radar and advised negative, nothing on radar within 60-mile radius of the Youngstown area. Again, he did verify they have no contact with any helicopter or private-owned vehicles that might be in the area. We are continually getting calls on this, so...
What's the area?
Still Sampson Fifth Avenue.
We're right there. I don't see anything up in the air now. How long ago did these calls come in?
This just in within two.
This is air radio. 98th radio.
Dead.
If you get any more calls, try to get an address. I'd like to speak to the people making the calls, please.
Copy. Not any good.
I'll be out of service for a few minutes. I have to gather my thoughts.
Huh. Happy gathering, 58.
Hello, Art.
Hi, Kenny.
Interesting stuff.
Yeah, I'm going to be out of service. I'll be gathering my thoughts. Copy gathering. Great.
Yeah.
These people had a serious sense of humor, didn't they?
Well, here's what I'd like to do, if we could just briefly. Let's look back here briefly at the FAA tower operator.
Okay, can I give you my observations?
Okay.
All right. That lady was screaming silently for that FAA guy to tell her, yeah, lady, look, it's a helicopter or it's a low-flying plane, and she couldn't make the guy say it.
Well, here's what, just my observations from listening to this.
Uh-huh.
He asked no questions.
That's right.
He really did not exhibit any curiosity about this. And shoot, you know, if something like this came up... if you were a tower operator, you'd be itching to get a little detail, wouldn't you?
Absolutely, because you're sitting there watching normal air traffic, bored as hell.
And think of this also. Now, this is just for our interest here to surmise on this. The FAA tower operator asked the dispatcher, "How close is this to a hospital?" And his reasoning for doing so would be maybe
helicopter.
To assert right that this could be a life flight helicopter.
Sure.
Now, why would he ask this if he turned around and said he has nothing on radar?
That's a very good point.
Usually,
Kenny.
Helicopters are not necessarily equipped with stealth technology.
That's right.
I mean, how about that? I mean, yeah, maybe a low-flying helicopter could could be off radar, but in most cases, radar can go down low. And in fact, they had an interview with a gentleman from the Cincinnati FAA tower several years ago, Bob Leibel with Natural Light Productions. He interviewed a tower operator that said that they can pick up trucks on the interstate.
Really?
With their FAA tower. So for that matter, why would he have suggested a life flight helicopter maybe as a explanation when he turned around and said he didn't even have anything on radar? I don't know. That's just my, you know, surmising.
That's one take, and it's a really good one, better than mine. Mine was that she continually was asking him to sort of sanction an explanation that she could turn around and give to the cops out there.
Hmm.
You know, she kept saying, couldn't it be a helicopter or a low-flying plane, or what can I tell them, she was saying.
Right.
And
right.
She wanted something to say on the radio. To her credit, she turned around and didn't say something that he didn't say.
Hmm. We have the next segment is about a 14-minute segment. Do we have time for that?
No, we don't have 14 clear minutes.
Okay.
We sure don't. So that's going to be a hot segment.
Yeah.
Anyway, there's lots we can do here. I would like to set up a period of time where some people in the audience would have an opportunity to give you their observations. I mean, people are going to be itching to say what they think about this, so I might just sit here and take a couple of calls.
Sure.
You want to do that?
Sure thing.
All right. I don't want to interrupt a 14-minute segment, so I'm going to pick up a couple of lines here and see what people have to say. West of the Rockies, you're on the air with Kenny Young and Art Bell. Hi. No, I didn't push the button. Sorry, Kenny. Now you're on the air, west of the Rockies. Hello. Hello there.
Hi.
Hi. Turn your radio off, please.
I will.
There you go.
There you go.
That's good. Where are you?
In Lassen County in California.
And what do you think about what you've heard so far?
I was concerned about the prostate problem, about ordering those pills.
That's kind of a different subject, dear. We have them. The prostate product is advertised here. I don't have the 800 number offhand, but it'll come up again shortly.
Well, I'm with the cost of medical things. People have a lot of money, and if they don't have any, and you're advertising pills that will cure them, instead of going to a doctor, they'll take your pills. Is that worth one life?
I wouldn't be able to tell you now. I'm sorry. Thank you. First time caller line, you're on the air with Art Bell and Kenny Young.
Hey, good evening, gentlemen.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Are you calling about prostate pills?
Yeah. This is Mike from Sherman Oaks, California.
Yes, Mike.
Listening to you on 790 KABC Talk Radio.
Yes, sir.
Great stuff.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
I watched Confirmation, and I want to say that this is even more compelling than what they had. I've have never seen anything, shall we say, but I've been reading everything I can get my hands on since I was a wee nipper. So
a wee nipper.
And I'm like on the edge of the seat. I've got the tape recorder going, and I'm taping every bit of this.
Good for you.
It's excellent.
It really is. Your impression so far with regard to the Confirmation debunker who said, Star?
what's he smoking? I want some. For anything out there, I mean, even Roswell, I mean, I cannot understand how people can say, oh, yeah, it's not happening. It's Venus. It's swamp gas.
You can say it, or possibly somebody can even pay you to say it.
I don't know. It's.
But I can't imagine you voluntarily say it.
Yeah, exactly.
Especially on national TV.
What is it? The truth is out there, and we are not alone.
Thanks for the call. Wildcard line, you're on the air with Kenny Young and Art Bell. Hi.
Hi, Art. Bill from Youngstown, Ohio. I know Toby Malero, and I also know one of the callers that called the woman.
Toby then was one of the officers?
Yeah, he's the one, kind of a chubby guy. He's a cop.
Okay.
And I listened to you all night, and I usually on a break go up to an all-night supermarket, and I ran into him at that time. And he knows that I'm psychic, and he's not a real believer, but we used to kibitz, and he'd ask me a psychic question. And I said, Tony, you're going to see a UFO? And he said to me, I already have. Never forget this. But what they showed on the TV thing What he described to me were two totally different scenarios. He saw something hovering over a house, covering the house and the entire lot. The lots on Sampson Road would have a frontage of 120 to more because it's a high and high scenario real estate over there. And he said it was red, so red that he couldn't look at it. It was blind. Now, that's not what they did in the show. They showed him looking above his car. At
no, every thank you very much. Every program like this takes some dramatic license. And what you see visually in terms of a presentation as NBC put together may or may not reflect accurately what was described. Kenny, do you have any comments on that?
Well, you know, that's basically true. I think that when I saw the piece, that was my first impression because it was back in 96 when I interviewed the officer that the detail that he gave about what he saw did not include a structure. And they showed on the confirmation piece the little looks like a spaceship from outer space with
That's
a little
right.
bitty spinning wheel on it or something
yep,
like
yep,
that.
Yep, exactly right.
And well, yeah, you're right that you know they do have a
even in the case of Travis Walton, who was abducted, and then they did a movie called Fire in the Sky, and I had Travis and I had his boss on the air, and they both said dramatic license, you know, when it comes to actually showing what something or another
right.
looked like. You know, they,
exactly.
TV shows do that. There's nothing like hearing the real thing, which you've got. We may have time for one more. East of the Rockies, you're on the air with Kenny Young and Art Bell. Hi. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Turn your radio off, please.
It's off.
Good for you. Where are you?
Mount Auburn, Ohio.
Okay. Ohio again. Good. What do you have to say about all this?
I've lived up here for quite a while now, and I've sat outside, and I've seen, like, flying objects flying northwest towards Cincinnati and the Youngstown area.
You mean like airplanes?
No, sir. They low to the tree line that me and my dad both have seen them. They'll stay low to the trees. One minute they'll have, like, real bright glowing lights that'll, like, rotate, and then it'll just disappear, and it'll appear later on over the horizon at another angle.
So not stars?
No, sir.
You know a star when you see it?
I've seen several stars, and none of them has moved like that.
All right. I'm sorry, we're woefully...
This is Coast to Coast AM with Art Bell. Now again, here's Art.
Once again, here I am. What you're hearing is totally incredible. It's from Kenny Young in Cincinnati, and you're hearing the raw 911 footage during this entire incident in Trumbull County, and it's astounding. Nothing short of astounding. Pop a prostate pill and keep listening. Once again is Kenny Young, and back to Trumbull County we go. Kenny?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
hello.
We've got a long segment coming up. What are we about to hear?
Okay, I guess maybe a little bit behind here, so we better start pegging the tape down.
Okay.
The next segment we're going to hear, let me explain real quick here about the recording process at the 911 center. They have a multi-track recorder so that the different of frequencies and of phone lines go to different channels on the tape.
Correct.
The following information was derived from a certain channel that I think did not go out over a scanner frequency, but it nevertheless was recorded on the tape.
Okay.
So let's just go ahead and take off from there.
Fire away.
Back to the UFO, I saw it.
Did you really?
But if it was red, I don't know. People say it's blue. I pull up to this.
County just saw it too.
Down. He goes, hey, this thing's hovering right over Sodom Hutchins. It just came over my house, right? I said, are you serious? He goes, yeah, right? Then you tell me you got a report of it on Fifth Avenue Extension, right?
Yeah.
I'm right by Patty Metzinger's house, and I looked towards Fifth Avenue Extension.
Uh-huh.
You could see a red glow up in the sky. It was huge. It was like huge.
See, but they're telling me blue-green because the media called. This woman was crying hysterically. She's like, oh, my God. And she's screaming. And they're like, oh, God. And they call me.
I'm laughing it off because I can't, you know, I'm not going to cause a panic. We don't.
You know, I'm for some issues, right?
No, because you told me, I swear to God, we got 7 to 8 calls on this UFO.
We're doing, they're scanning us.
No, I'm telling you what, they were coming in at the same time. They were coming at the same time.
Why did I see this?
And the county saw it. Somebody from the county saw it.
Really?
I think Pete Lusick saw it because he came across his channel and he goes, he's that big thing in the sky with the lights. And first we thought they were making fun of us, but they went to another channel to do it because they didn't want to be on their main.
Well, with me, I saw this big red sort of glow in the sky.
Well, that's what the guy said. He said it looked like fighter pilot lights in the back of the tail of a bomber.
Yeah, that's what it looked.
And I said, you know, I said, well, maybe it's a weather balloon. Well, I called up, and Toby, I swear to you, I was laughing it off, and I thought, well, he's going to say weather balloon or something, but he says, no, I don't know. He goes, we have nothing. He goes, we have, and he's trying to give me numbers to report it, and I'm saying no. I don't want any numbers. He's going, well, he goes, you know, I don't have anything in the 16-mile radius of Youngstown. He goes, I'm looking at the radar right now.
Well, this thing wasn't more than about 50 feet off the ground.
Well, that's what I told him. I said, this is low to the ground. I said, you might not pick it up. I said, you know, I said, he goes, well, maybe it's a helicopter. I said, well, I heard from 4 people something that low to the ground would be making a hell of a noise.
This thing wasn't making no noise.
I know.
Because I rolled down, when I saw the glove, I rolled down my window. I didn't hear a sound. The only sound I heard was my car.
Well, was it moving or was it just...
Yeah, it was glowing. It was moving. You could see it like up in the air glowing and getting further away from me. That's why I had to go all the way down to Overbrook and cut over to get on 6th Avenue. As soon as I turned on 6th Avenue, that is the dip.
Did Bob see it?
No.
Did Steve see it?
No. I'm the only one that saw it.
There's about 10 other people in Liberty who are just swearing up and down. They saw a UFO.
Oh,
they'll have a ball with it because, I mean, they called already.
Did you guys locate anything?
Yeah, well, they're like, people are serious. They're very upset. And I'm like, well, it's got to be a weather balloon or something. And I knew it wasn't a weather balloon because they, you know,
well,
FAA would know about it.
Foxy said it was green and blue lights?
Green, well, no. The media said it was green and blue lights. I had a man who said it was huge and it doesn't make any noise.
That's what I saw.
And I said, could it be like a weather balloon? He goes, no. He goes, these lights are incredibly bright. And he goes, and this thing's just hovering. It's not moving. And I said, well, maybe it's a private plane or something.
This thing, whatever it was, lit up. You could stand, if you were underneath it, you could see it would be like daylight, but red light.
Well, I logged it. I know this is coming back up. I know everybody and their brother's going to be calling tomorrow. And I'm like, I logged it.
And I saw it. Oh, my God.
No, I didn't like you saw it.
They're going to be calling.
But you know what? They'll be pulling that tape. We're all going to get our asses shook. You watch, federal government will come out here and go, okay, we're going, oh, little green men, Santa Claus, flying Christmas tree, all this shit on the channel. We're all going to get our asses in a grinder. Maybe I want to. So, I don't know. If it was a UFO, it's logged, you know. But, I mean, you saw it. If you saw it.
Well,
what did you think it was? What did you really think it was?
I don't know. I didn't hear me. I came across it. So whatever it is, it's big.
But you know what? I know you play. You know what I mean? I know you joke around. That's what I said.
I wasn't joking. I was not joking.
For a minute, it didn't sound like you were. I mean, you were laughing, and then all of a sudden, you weren't laughing. And I thought, well, maybe he's trying to make me, like, think there's really this UFO there. And I was like, oh.
No, I wasn't joking. I saw a large red light up.
Hold on 1 second. Howling guy, you think some of UFO expert he was talking to me. You want me to let you go?
Yeah, I'll talk to you later.
Okay, sweetheart. Take care. Bye bye. You just asked. Can I help you?
Yeah, this is Alan 433.
Hey, 433.
How are you doing?
Yeah, pretty good.
Liberty was spotting earlier.
Oh, cut it out.
No, I'm serious.
You
We've been watching it for about 10 minutes now.
Your ass.
No, I'm serious.
Man.
Go straight out your door.
Hold on.
I'm on Henhide.
Where is it at?
I'm on Henhide, okay?
Come get me. I want to go see this. Is it outside? Can I, like, see it from here?
Oh, you'll see it.
Here.
I can't believe
plug
it.
Plug into me. All right, I'm going to go out and look at it now.
All right. If you're up high enough, it's straight east of you.
It's east of me?
Straight east of you. Look straight up.
Which way do I go when I... Okay. Up.
You know where Kane Drive is across from the hospital?
So, plug in for me. I'm going to go out. Liberty. Get Howlin' Liberty. I'm going to run out. Stay on the phone.
Okay.
Okay? I'm coming back. I'll tell you if I see it.
Okay.
Okay.
Wow.
I got a big down there. All right. Down there, something went through the
out there, you see it? Yeah, that thing has not moved in 10 minutes that I've been watching it. Come up on Henhide and start south off of King's Grave if you're on Henhide. Come on down, you'll see me park. I've been watching this thing through my binoculars. I can't quite make it out. It changes colors from white to red to green. You know, those are colors of planes, but this sucker has not moved. It hasn't gone any direction since I've been watching it. It's a good 10 minutes.
It's an alien. It's an alien.
Yeah, it's an alien, all right.
Prove it.
Hello.
She went outside, too, back in a minute.
Okay. I couldn't believe it. I was just putting by my house, and I looked over, you know, laughingly thinking, because we had one 2 weeks ago. And I looked over, and I said, oh, here's a plane coming in to land, you know, because I'm used to seeing those. This thing has not moved in 10 minutes. And it's too bright and too low, and it changes colors to be a star.
It's an alien that came down to steal all our Christmas presents.
Yeah, I wish. Hang on,
it's Santa Claus.
Go ahead, 429. You see my car down on Henhide, about half to a quarter of a mile, somewhere in there, down from King's Grave.
Okay, you got a pretty good view out here on King's Grave.
Okay, you see it? I mean, I got a perfect view where I'm at. I just can't quite make it out through my binoculars.
Can you go to
14? Right, I'm on public service too, so hang on, I'm trying to juggle mics. Okay, I'm on 14. You got copies?
Yeah, it looks like I'm getting pretty close here, but I can't really judge how far out it is, you know?
Oh, I've been stationary since I called you. Now, however long it took you to come from over on the west side, that bugger has not moved.
Yeah, well, I'm going over 11 right now, and it looks like I'm starting to maybe get next to it here. But it's still out a good ways.
See it? No, see it down over here just above the trees. Yeah. Okay, has it moved any? It looked like it might have flickered a little in that, because it's moving slightly. Okay, Mikey's up here with me now. He's looking through the binocs. It looks like it might have moved just slightly because it moved from one side of a tree to another, but it's still visible right here where we're at.
About 11.
Okay, well,
I'm
going to use
about 11.
Ridge
already. Ridge at the air base.
You say you're at Ridge at the air base? Okay, it should be south of you, right?
Yes, sir.
Looks like it's doing circles. Looks like it's doing circles?
Yeah.
But,
this is moving.
What
area is it in?
Huh?
What area?
Hang on one sec. Davey, what area do you think it's in now? Hang on a second. Okay, where you're at and where I'm at, I'm about a half a mile south of King's Grave on Henhide.
Henhide, half a mile south of King's Grave.
It's still a little bit south of me, so where are you at as far as on Ridge Road?
Do
you guys have to take pee tests at all, Howard? Because we went outside, we didn't see anything. They all see it. We were all on Henhide. We didn't see it.
Okay, well, we're on Henhide north of Kane. Okay, there's a brand new house under construction, and we're watching it right through the empty field.
You're seeing it through the field?
Yeah, we're seeing all our cars.
How big
are parked
is it? What color is it? Because I got three of them.
It ranges from like a whitish red to pulsating greenish lavender.
Do you see any red? It was a whole red light. You said it looked like.
Well, from the distance, I mean, I can't tell. My binoculars are a cheap set of binoculars. I thought I saw some red. Let me check with Dave from his angle. Do you see red and green on it? Hey, Dave, from your angle,
I'll call the
airplane. See a pulsating red and green?
I'm telling you, we went outside, we didn't see anything.
Yeah, what?
I'm calling the air base again.
Okay.
Hold on, just stay on the line.
I've gladly come down and pick you up in the car for you.
I want to see it. Come get me.
All right.
Come get me.
All right.
I'll be outside.
All right. Okay.
All right. I need a break. He's going to take me to see it.
Priceless, Kenny. I've never heard anything like it, except one other incredible tape. I don't know if you ever heard the Michigan tape that I had. Have you ever heard that?
Yes, I sure have.
This is right up there in that class, Kenny. There's no question about it. We could discuss. You know, earlier she was saying the media will have a ball with this. She was already estimating they were going to get 1 million calls the next day.
Right.
Apparently they didn't. And then I also noted one officer who said that it moved from across a tree, from one side of the tree to the next. Mm-hmm. Isn't that what I heard?
Sure, right.
That's what I heard, yeah. So a star wouldn't do that, Kenny, in terms of a close reference object. There's no way in hell a star would do that. We'll
what
be right back.
What we're going to get into next here is the police pursuit.
All right. All good. All right. Stay right there. Have you guys heard anything like this before?
And now, back to the best of Art Bell.
One more quick facts. Art, what a wonderful build, and ultimately a telling commentary on the effect of non-humanity on humanity. There is no more dramatic reality than offered by those involved in the denial of reality, except, of course, a prostate disorder. And actually, there is one more, and this will sort of back up Kenny. Kenny, here's somebody who writes, Art, I'm concerned that the FAA tower person was not concerned that an object might be in commercial airspace unbeknownst to him. It's a safety issue. That's another Greg from Washington. What do you think, Kenny?
Well, that's a good point. You know, I guess we can look into this and find all kind of little particulars.
No, but
back
I mean,
then, we just don't know.
I mean, you're talking to a radar guy, and he ought to be concerned about something not on his radar, yes?
Well, we're thinking from our perspective. Of course, we don't know who the radar tower operator was.
Our silly perspective is normal people.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. All right. We have coming up what you're calling the chase, huh?
Okay, and I'll play the tape, and I guess what we'll have to do is you'll just have to break in whenever you need to, because we'll play the tape through this segment.
Go for it.
Okay.
You got it.
Containing a lot of a noise that we'll get from the radio traffic, but that'll give you a little flavor for what's happening here.
All right.
433-429.
Go ahead.
Okay, is it moved down from where you're at? I'm going down to pick up another person.
Negative. I'm out of the air base here. We're standing here watching this.
Keep a visual on and let me know, because I want to pick this person up, but I'm about 30 seconds away from picking them up.
Okay, looks like he's just sitting here.
Okay. 433 subjects en route. Where's King?
Okay, I'll be there in under 30 seconds.
Oh,
call the Air Force Base. See what they have going on.
I was looking at it through the binoculars. It looks like it has something protruding out the top of it.
Okay, you must have better binoculars than what I said, because I couldn't quite make it on. I'm going to try to stomp on film on it and see if I can't get a better look at it.
Okay, does it seem like you're any closer to it?
Yeah, definitely closer than your location, because it's still south of me. It's southeast. Southeast of Old 82.
Okay. Why
now.
Registration
when you can.
98 to radio.
998.
Okay. I don't know what this is. It's some large light in the sky. It seems to be changing colors once in a while. We tried to signal it. Head back. Brookfield, wherever it is, I don't know. It's pretty far from us.
10-4-459.
Hey, are we talking about this white light over top of the airbase? Yeah, that's probably it. That light isn't pulsating right here. It just looks like a star or something up there. How far are you from the airbase? Southeast of there looks to be rather high, though, not just over the tree line. Well, it's not not much, probably. And south out this way. Ah, oh, well, I don't have any way to get there. Okay.
A few people there that were saying it's a star, get more sleep.
Right.
Where do we go from here? Do we eventually hear from the man who climbed the tower?
Right. Yes. And there's some very exciting parts still to come. And we need to get more into the star explanation at this
All
point
right.
too, after hearing this last part.
Very good. Stay right there, Kenny, as the unadulterated raw sound footage comes to you about what occurred in Trumbull County. I'm Art Bell, and this is Coast to Coast AM.
This is Coast to Coast AM from the Kingdom of Nye.
My guest is Kenny Young. What you're hearing is the real thing from Trumbull County, from several police departments in Trumbull County. Also, I should mention I have something else here in my possession that I'm afraid to read. I'll read just the introduction to it, Art. The following is an official department document. It's from a police department. Please use your discretion should you mention it on the air. Just wanted to let you know that some people do take Y2K seriously. It looks like Y2K readiness is not a joke in blank, the name of the city. If you could say a hello to officers Lou, Steve, and Doug, it'd be appreciated later in the show. We got to get off at 15:30 hours Eastern Standard Time. Actually, you've got that wrong. That'd be in the afternoon, military time. So he must mean 3:30 or something like that. Love the show. We in law enforcement are avid listeners. The document itself is instructions on what will occur around Y2K time, leave restrictions. And I wish I could read it to you, but I would get people in trouble if I did. It is a very sobering document. In a moment, we'll get back to Kenny in Trumbull County. All right. No delay. Right back to Kenny Young. Kenny, welcome back.
Thanks a lot, Art.
How do you want to proceed? Do you want to go back to it, or do you want to make a comment on the SAR thing now?
Let's briefly comment on what we just heard. I think that the last segment was really compelling.
Yes.
It was the police pursuit, and we do get indications that they have triangulated the object's position as they approach from varying places. That's kind of difficult to do, I guess, if it were a star. You know, there's a saying, it's like if it's too good to be true, it probably is. You know, it's not true.
Right.
In this case, we do have a possibility that this entire situation is kind of like obfuscated or, you know, compounded by the misidentification of stars, especially during the police pursuit sequence.
Well, it may well have been that one or two of them were seeing a star, describing a star.
Sure,
and
They, even at one point in the tape, I think that they do acknowledge that, yes, what I saw at that time was a star. So that's a given. So that's where I think that it's a viable possibility to suggest that. However, you know, from what we've heard...
No. Well, it isn't to me. It's not viable to me, Kenny. My assessment so far, now maybe I'll hear something else, but my assessment is that some of the officers, I mean, obviously there are stars out, so they saw a bright star. There are bright stars in the sky, but that doesn't even get close to undercutting the very direct, very dramatic, very specific, it's just above my head, just above my house, just above this street,
right?
Kind of thing. No way.
Oh, I agree with you.
All right.
There are, you know, there's segments of it that's what makes this case compelling.
All right. Well, why don't we continue?
Okay. What we have from this point, now this was a segment that was on the television program Confirmations with the officer who went to the tower.
Right.
And actually, Confirmations somewhat took that out of context and out of sequence.
Okay.
The part where he went to the tower, we actually had already heard. And he did make references to that. He was in the tower. So we're going to hear the part that they presented, but he was, I think, in his patrol cruiser at the time, not in the tower.
All right.
So here we go. I'll play this segment.
Hey, it's Edgar.
Yeah.
All right, I talked to these guys. Everything's all right. They're going to go back to where they came from.
Who?
I can see them.
Did you see anything?
I got them right here. I'm looking at them.
What the hell is it?
Hold on a second. I got to turn my lights on before I get rear-ended.
Okay.
Well, I can see them from Warner Road. They're sitting stationary. I got three of them.
Uh-huh.
One is over, well, there, and then there's two kind of close together.
What do they look like?
Well, I'd like to say that they're just like flickering stars, except I've got four discernible colors. I got red, yellow, green, and blue, and the one just was like flashing. So if they're those planets those guys were talking about, then they're planets with Christmas lights on.
You can see them?
I can see them. Not like clear as day. I don't see any wings or anything to keep them.
But you see lights?
Yeah.
Unreal.
Hold on a second.
Unreal. What are you doing?
That's what I mean. I mean, I can, without my binoculars, I can see red, yellow, green, and blue. I mean, they're way over there. They got to be way over in Cortland.
No. Did you hear Cortland on the air?
Yeah.
The UFOs will come into Cortland.
I can't believe it.
He's killing me. So you're having an experience?
No, because I can't see. I mean, they look, they're so far away, they look like stars.
Mm-hmm.
They're just like kids.
Well, the first calls we got from Liberty were they were like 50 feet above the ground.
Yeah, well, they could be on their way home.
All right. I think everyone else in this county should go home.
Yeah, I'm already here. This is weird. I had a beat on them from the tower. They were close. They got to be going away because they were closer than this. Now I'm looking at them. Oh my God.
What?
And they're not a plane because here goes a plane and I can see the plane and the plane's blinking red and the fact that there's another plane.
I think.
I think they're scrambling planes out of SATCOM 1 to go check them out.
Wait a minute.
What?
Oh, my God, I hope that's a plane. Oh, Jesus Christ, please be a plane. Oh, please.
Come on, what are you doing?
I ain't ready for this shit. Hold on. Little bitch, where'd you go? That's a plane. Oh, thank God.
Well, I get nervous when they're coming right at me.
There's three planes up there. I'll tell you what, they're flying from the Air Force Base.
Really?
Something's got to be.
Oh, really?
Yeah, hold on. I'm about to get drilled again.
Where are you?
Right here.
Wait, where are you?
Warner Road, south of Merlin Chase.
Really?
Four up there now. There's four planes.
Oh, okay.
So what? The other things are still there.
Uh-huh.
But these are like,
what do you don't feel?
Pricks. All right, what are we doing with this now, Pete?
I have no idea.
Well, you know what? I can tell it's not in our airspace, so it ain't our call.
Okay.
I'll talk to you later.
Bye.
Bye.
Yes. The Air Force Base will get back to you, but what this possibly could be.
Negative, they advised, did not show up on the radar. Negative, so we'll check for one.
Okay.
Hey, I got to look through this thing at a telescope.
Okay.
Okay, we were looking ahead. It is a planet.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but ironically, while everybody else was watching it, a couple of the Niles guys had a night vision scope. Some lady who says she lives in Liberty came up to them. They're down here on the strip.
Okay.
And asked them, are you guys tracking the UFO? And they looked at her and thought she was joking. She says, dead ass serious. She says the thing was in her backyard.
I'm telling you, I told you, that woman said she was in her backyard.
Yeah.
She said, it was in my backyard, it was in the field, and she was having a fit about it. Would you please go from here, please?
So anyhow, she's telling them, and they said, well, is that what you saw? She turns around and looks at us. She goes, you know, she goes, that's a planet. She goes, that's not what we saw.
This thing was red, and Toby said it was right near the ground. He said it lit up the sky.
Ah, okay.
And I'm like, well, it was pretty far away from all of us. You know, we really can't make a good determination, but there's that chance, you know. And
well, for about the last 35 minutes, we've been tracking this with a telescope, and it's moving in a set arc, you know, which would be with the rotation.
Okay.
It's a planet. Which one? God only knows. But it's a planet. It's not a star.
Well, we were all excited.
Oh, I know I was too. I think God
something.
But definitely something else is, you know, whatever, you know, I don't dispute what the lady's saying, but just thought it was funny that somebody came all the way down into Niles, either on her way to work or whatever.
Yeah, said, what the hell are you looking at now? That's
yeah.
not what I saw. No, Toby said, he said, you know, it was, there's no way that, he said, that did not look what he, you know, look like what he saw.
Okay.
I do not know, you know, if it was the distance or what the situation was. But if that's a planet, that's a planet. It's pretty damn low, but...
Oh, yeah. Well, like I said, it was lower when we first saw it, and like I said, we've been sitting down here on the strip, just, you know, everybody's sitting still, not moving,
uh-huh.
and we every so often we had to adjust the telescope, so it's moving, but it's arcing in a set pattern,
uh-huh.
so it looks like it's stationary, other than it's a little higher than, you know, like where I'm at right now, I can see it where before I know I wouldn't have been, because I'm down here at the corners, you know, that's even lower than the center, and I can see it now, so... Oh, well.
Okay.
All righty.
Thanks for calling.
Is there any more calls on it?
No, nothing else.
All right. Well, we'll probably all have a lot of answers today.
I'll tell you what. It's enough for me. Thanks for calling.
All right, you take care.
Bye-bye.
Okay, hello, Art. Yeah, hi, Kenny.
Okay.
All right, so, you know, what I heard at the end was two people comforting each other by rationalizing. That's what I heard. What did you hear?
Well, you know, this is the gentleman's being very candid by admitting, well, what we've been looking at has been a star.
Well, he's saying what he's looking at is a star.
Right.
And he made a rational, very literate explanation of how he was tracking it in an arc,
right.
and so forth and so on. But that doesn't at all add up with what all the close eyewitnesses said.
Well, you know, I'll tell you what, if you want to just draw a little picture here of what's happening here, and we just heard the drama of the tapes, to see these the county police agencies rattled like this, I can almost see in my mind a picture of the police cars sitting on the side of the road with their lights off and all the officers frozen, fixed in a position, gazing into the sky. It's just an odd situation, something like you'd see out of a Steven Spielberg movie.
Precisely. By the way, Kenny, on confirmation, they showed an officer whose car engine stopped. Now, I may have missed it in here somewhere, but was that in here?
Right, yes. That was, in fact, in the in one of the first segments that we heard after he needed time to gather his thoughts, he said.
Oh,
prior to that.
Then I've got to go back and listen. This is one of those things that you cannot listen to one time.
Right,
you really
right.
got to listen and dissect it.
And in fact, when you hear it again, it's even better.
Really?
Yes. There's things in there that it's like a good movie. You want to see it again and you get more out of it the next time around.
Absolutely astounding stuff. I mean, really astounding. And what I'd like to do with the last portion we have, I take it that is the tape in total?
Right. That's
All right.
It.
What I would like to do, if you can stick around for one last portion, is to answer some lines and get some impressions of the audience now that they've heard the entire thing.
Okay.
Is that all right?
Sounds good.
All right. Stay right there, Kenny. Now, listen, everybody. For those of you who did not have an opportunity to tape it, poor you. To get a copy of this program, it's going to be a four-hour program. The number is 1-800-917-4278. I can well understand this is one you're going to want to archive. 1-800-917-4278. Now, I'm getting already zillions of inquiries, and so please write the number down. It's good 24 hours a day, beginning right now, a four-hour program on Trumbull County. 1-800-917-4278. I'm not sure anybody else has ever done anything like this on the air, quite like this. So, in the next segment, the final segment, we'll take your calls.
Here again is Art.
Listen, I need to catch you up on one thing. The Federal Communications Commission, despite reports yesterday on CNN and elsewhere, has made a statement that we have on our website right now that's going to cause you to have a big sigh of relief. The Federal Communications Commission is denying outright that they have plans to allow implementation of per-minute charges on the Internet. Thought you'd want to know, thought you should know. You can check out the statement on our website at www.artbell.com, which will lead you to Kenny Young's website, who has brought us so much this night. Welcome back.
Thank you, Art.
All right. I guess this is one of those things, just like everything else on my program, Kenny, where people are going to sit out there and they've listened to all this, they're going to digest it, and they're going to come up with their own opinion. But one thing's for sure, they were hearing the real thing as it occurred.
Right. It keeps the debate going.
Yeah. If it does that. Let's see what people think. First time caller line, you're on the air with Kenny Young and Art Bell. Hi.
Good morning, Mr. Bell. This is Tim up in Fairbanks. I have a couple of questions here.
Hi, Tim.
The tower guy. Now, yeah. Isn't this guy under some sort of unwritten rule, kind of like the airliner captains, that even if you see something, it's a hush-hush situation or else you may lose your job?
You mean the FAA man?
Yeah.
No, I agree with a lady who sent the fax and who said it's a public safety issue. In other words, the FAA is there to control airspace, and if something's in airspace that shouldn't be, he should be really interested, asking a lot of questions. And
right, but he wouldn't admit it to the public. It's like an airline pilot. He wouldn't go on the news and say,
look, you're right. I mean, it's one of the cops said, Kenny, didn't he, that... Look, he didn't believe that there was nothing there, and he suggested the National Weather Service be called, which
right.
is, by the way, exactly what saw the UFO in Michigan, or the
right.
UFOs.
Well, this FAA tower that we're talking about here at Youngstown, at the time it was manned by just one person, possibly, over the third shift duty. This also serves as a military tower. It controls... airspace for the Youngstown Warren Regional Airport and also for the air base.
Well, that might explain a lot.
Yeah. One quick question here. Aren't police cars, do they have camcorders on their dash or at least Polaroids in their trunks for accident times? Why wasn't there any pictures of this?
Very good question. I think not all police departments, of course, have camcorders.
Right.
That's a pretty new thing.
That was something I tried to get details about. I think, like you say, Art, they don't all have them. This was 94, so I think today you're more apt to find
yep.
something like that.
Yep. However, he was right about the Polaroids. However, It may. I wonder if there are some private Polaroids circulating about.
Well, I'd be curious to know if there's a private home video somewhere.
That too.
That would be the thing that would be very interesting.
And I would assume, Kenny, they can get hold of you through your website, email, that kind of thing.
Right.
All right. Excellent. Wildcard Line, you're on the air with Kenny Young and Art Bell. Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
It is a pleasure to speak with you.
Glad to have you, sir. Where are you?
I'm in Marysville, Ohio.
Okay.
Near where they make Hondas.
All right.
What I am listening to, this is Dennis, by the way.
Yes, sir.
Now all my friends will say, I heard you on the radio with Art. They love you. I love you.
Well, thank you.
What this leads me to believe.
I'm not going to have your baby.
No, just send me my QSL card already.
All right.
What this leads me to believe is that whatever is there wants to have nothing to do with us, or they really would talk to us. That once in a while, they let it be known that they're there, but they want to have nothing to do with us.
That is, that's actually a fairly reasonable conclusion. Thank you. Kenny, how do you react to that? I mean, really, if you digest what we have here, what we had in Michigan and so many other places, it's hard to name.
Yeah.
Then he's right, really. In other words, they're observing. They're on occasion allowing themselves to be seen, as in Phoenix, for example.
Well,
but they don't want to contact us.
I would. The motive behind a speculation like that would be to, I guess, surmise that this is something extraterrestrial. Let's look at it from a different point of view, however. We don't know for sure about the subject of extraterrestrials or, you know, things like that. This is something where we look at what we're dealing with, and that is an unidentified flying object.
Yes, and okay. As you pointed out, though, the FAA controller also was involved with the military control. Now, if there was a secret military mission underway,
That's what I like to inquire about. Now, what if there was something like that?
Then you might get that kind of attitude from the controller.
It's possible, but let me ask you this: why would this be done over a residential neighborhood? I mean, I would think of a numerous
Beats the hell out of me.
Safety concerns.
And there were just too many things that, despite the rationalization at the end, pointed not to a star, but to something obviously low and big with substance. Now, those kind of comments just don't jive with a star thing.
Right.
All right. East of the Rockies, you're on the air with Kenny Young and Art Bell. Hi.
Aloha from Chattanooga.
Yes, sir.
This is Jeff, by the way. Thank you for taking my call, and thanks for the show.
Sure.
I think as far as the star goes, I think the each person's perspective has to be taken into account. I mean, you have two or three squad cars that are a couple blocks away, and they're seeing different things because it's so low. I mean, I think that has to be taken into account.
I think some of the officers were, in fact, looking at stars.
Right.
There's no question about it. But in the cases, whether from the civilians or the officers who got to see it close up, there's no way.
Right.
No way.
I think it's kind of interesting how it turned from a typical police situation into a, like Kenny was saying, like just people, like regular Joes just standing around, couldn't believe what they were seeing.
Precisely.
And trying to explain it.
That kind of wonderment and multiple police departments being involved over a star, I don't think so.
Right.
What engendered this incident to begin with is what I'd like to know. If it did degenerate to a situation involving misidentification of stars, what's happened initially to start all this with the citizen reports to the 911 center?
Yeah. Yeah, I don't buy any of that. West of the Rockies, you're on the air with Kenny Young and Art Bell. Where are you, please?
I am Hollywood, California.
Hollywood. Right. Hollywood.
Yep.
Yes, sir.
Yep. Where the movies are done. This is incredible. It just sounds like something off a movie here.
Except it's not.
Yeah, that's what's really amazing. And A little side note for you. I was going to say, when you go on Larry King, it'd be better to try to fit in with probably a suit or something, because most people besides your listeners are going to probably think you're off base pretty much. If you dress unusually, they
might...
Yeah,
but you know what? I really don't care.
Yeah, well, that's the point. And I see that you spend a lot of time on this radio station, and they have people look down at you, because this stuff is pretty serious stuff. This might have everything to do with us and the future and the past and everything wrapped together.
You have a good point. It's really a good point.
Yeah,
even though it's tempting for me.
It's nice. If you went there in a suit, a lot of people who were probably disbelievers will look at you and go, well, he looks
serious. No, I'm not going in a suit. No
well,
way.
Well, something nice.
No, well, something nice, but not
you're wearing like a pirate shirt.
Well, yeah, that's me, you know.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, if I were, normally, I've been on TV a few times, hard copy and stuff, and I wore a suit. I mean, if I went normally to where I normally look, people wouldn't take me seriously at all.
if I wear a suit, that's not me, and I'd rather have people think, geez, he should have wore a suit, than I would have people saying, look at the fake. He doesn't wear suits. He looks stupid in a suit, and I do look stupid in a suit. I'm not going to wear a suit.
Well, the picture of you on your book looks pretty good. It looks sort of dark and ominous. That looks pretty neat.
Well, that's me, dark and ominous.
Yeah, that looks great.
All right, sir.
Anyway, but back to the thing here. I was wondering, it's very important if we had some video on this, and the officer as well. You still there?
Yes.
Okay. The officer, Will, the guy who stopped for a second to gather his senses, maybe he should be regressed. Maybe they stopped time and did something with him.
Now, I agree with you, absolutely. I thought that also was a very dramatic moment, Kenny, when he said he's got to gather himself.
Right. He was shaken. He did tell me that in a phone conversation. He was shaken by this, had his car affected, blinding light. I guess that would shake anyone.
It would, and it just isn't typical of what Venus would do. First time caller line, you're on the air with Kenny Young and Art Bell. Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
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 Hello, hello.
Hello, hello.
This is Shall We Dance or Shall We Talk? Where are you?
I'm in North Carolina.
North Carolina.
Yes.
Well, you don't say hello out there anyway. You say hey.
Hey. I was just listening to the show. I listened from the net, and I think the video stream is very cool.
It is. Totally
and,
cool, yes.
What I wanted to mention was, how can so many people see this and they can deny it? Like, it doesn't, like, it's not there.
I think that to some degree, it's the normal human condition after you have had something like this happen to you, to go into a state of denial so that you don't have to face what otherwise is going to be the answer.
Yeah, I know what you mean. But it seems to me like, you know, there's very many people that are so closed-minded to this that, you know, they're just so set in their ways that they'll only believe, you know, what their government tells them to believe, as far as what I can tell.
Yeah, there was actually a lot of that. At one point, he again makes a good point. At one point, there was a reference to a weather balloon. Now, that's pop culture UFO answer time.
Right.
Remember that, Kenny?
Yes, sure. I think the news media is largely to blame, too.
It is. Because people with a sort of a chuckle in their voice come up with a standard response answer.
Mm-hmm.
No question about it. All right. Wild card line, you're on the air with Kenny Young and Art Bell. Hi.
Yes, this is Bruce from the Woodlands, Texas.
Hi, Bruce.
Hi. The thing that intrigues me is the plasma, the colors, and that's what I'm always listening for to try and determine what the propulsion method is. That's very intriguing. And also, it seemed as though there was some interference in the RF background at some point. I don't know. I had a real quick comment on another Y2K issue.
Okay, that's for another show, sir.
Oh, okay.
I appreciate your comments on this, though.
All righty.
And take care. First-time caller line, you're on the air with Kenny Young and Art Bell. Hi.
Hi, Art. How are you doing tonight?
Well, it's been quite a night.
Yes, indeed. I'm calling from Youngstown,
right now.
Oh, no kidding.
And I had the fortune of listening to the last 2 hours of the show with my Trumbull County roadmap in front of me.
Uh-huh.
And I was basically tracking the police officers and where they said they were going. And I think you guys will find this interesting. Remember how originally they said that they were tracking it southeast towards a place called Brookfield?
Yes.
And then the star that they ended up looking at was in a place called Cortland?
Yes.
Well, you'll be interested to know that from the airport, Brookfield is approximately 10 miles east by southeast,
okay,
whereas Cortland is 10 miles north by northwest.
Not the track the star would have taken.
Not at all. So, and nobody saw anything backtracking. So it sounds like whatever that thing did is it either took off, or the only thing that from the descriptions that they were giving, perhaps somebody was taking a night flight in a hot air balloon.
Look, there's no way in hell that what we heard, for the most part, was people pondering quietly whether they were seeing a star or not, twinkling.
Oh, they were definitely chasing something towards Brookfield, that's for certain.
That's for certain is right.
But here's what's interesting, too, is toward the end of the tape, the officer was observing the jet planes, and he speculated they were from the military base.
And still nothing from the FAA.
So he was able to see the jet planes.
Well, actually, that tower that he was standing in is about 2 miles to the due east of it, and I'm sure he would have seen any plane coming in or taking off from that airport.
Yeah, right. I was thinking that if you had the coherence to see a jet plane and contrast that with a star, also saying, I see the stars, I see the jet planes, I see the UFOs.
That's right. Three of them.
Sure. What time did this apparently happen?
Well, the event itself, when I got the tapes, I was told that the tapes were they began recording at midnight, and the tape reel was from the midnight to 6 a.m. time frame.
Hmm.
So we heard like about a 6-hour event compacted down onto one tape. So
we
don't really have an accurate
Venus in the dead of night, you know.
We don't have the the reflection of real time.
So this went on for 6 hours.
Yes, the heated stuff happened within the first hour. The pursuit sequence, I believe, was within the second hour, and then I think from that point you hear the random discussions and so forth happen for the rest of the night.
Remarkable stuff.
It was quite a night. I've wondered where was I on that night in question, what was I doing that night?
Yeah, I wonder where I was that night. If I'd looked to the north, maybe I would have seen the whole thing.
Maybe you would have.
Yeah, indeed. All right. Have a good night, gentlemen.
You too. Thanks,
Thank
caller.
You.
East of the Rockies, you're on the air with Kenny Young and Art Bell. Hi.
Good morning, Art. How are you?
Just fine. Where are you?
Columbus, Ohio.
Ohio, all right. Your attention out there in Ohio, I see.
Yeah, I got a friend that was on the department up there at the time.
Oh, really?
And something no one knows about, how you had the fighters that basically scramble from the base right there.
Obviously.
Like the next day or so, DOD showed up, the Department of Defense, and
what?
Everything became hush-hush up there.
Now, how do you know that?
My friend was a deputy sheriff up there at the time, and he had friends on base, and everything was just locked up and sealed.
You know, it sounds to me like you should be interviewed by Kenny Young. Kenny?
If you could, I would like to talk to this person and get some details about this. And,
okay. I'll see what I can do if there's where I can get a hold of you off the air and stuff.
Okay. Yeah, sure thing. And, off the record or confidential, I'd like to get some details about
Kenny,
that.
Kenny, do you want to just go ahead and give out your email address?
Okay. Email address is ufo@fuse.net.
That's F-U-S-E, fuse?
Yes.
.net.
And the website address is home.fuse.net/UFO.
All right. And there is, for those of you who didn't get that, there's a link. Just go down to Kenny's name on my website, Kenny Young, and you'll see the link right there, and you can send him an email. Is that reasonable, caller?
Yeah. No problem at
all. All right. Then please do. Now, that's interesting. Have you heard anything like that before?
Well,
Gosh, you know, I got the tapes, I was told that there was some trouble obtaining the tapes at first, that they were missing.
Missing.
When the officers finally did get the date of the event, they went to retrieve the tapes and were kind of spooked when they found them missing, but I think they located a backup copy that was retained somewhere else at the center.
Oh, really?
That was interesting, and I kind of tried to follow up on that just a little bit, but I didn't really pursue it in depth. I didn't really, you know. How about that, though? You know, what can we say about that?
Well, what can we say about all of this? But it was a night of an anatomy of a sighting, and I want to thank you, Kenny Young, for bringing it to us. We're out of time.
Well, Art, thank you.
And
I enjoyed it.
It played out just right. Thank you, Kenny.
Thank you.
Good night. That's Kenny Young, and there you heard the real thing, the whole thing, what occurred in Trumbull County. And I guess, as always, you're adults, and you can make up your own mind. Listen, Sunday, Brad Steiger is going to be here on Dreamland. It's going to be quite a program. You don't want to miss it. For tonight, that's it. I'm Art Bell. Good night.